want to talk about slide rules. This is a slide rule, but to explain what it is, so what we have, a classic old school Faber-Castell slide rule. Anyone who is over 50 or maybe over 60 would have had to learn to use one of these at school. And actually, the use of mathematics for the previous 300 odd years required the use of this. And you could say that every single scientific invention, or you know, through the Age of Enlightenment, through you know, the 19th century, the 20th century, would have relied at some level on ease of calculation through using the slide rule.
And these are only a few out of the wide variety of problems that can be worked with the standard slide rule.
This is what scientists had. So it was shorthand for being a scientist. And it's so like wonderfully nerdy that I think the nerds were like, yeah, this is our sword.
It's our lightsaber.
Okay. It's actually rather lovely. The way this moves in and out, it's so beautifully done, this instrument. It's actually really pleasurable just going like this. The thing with a slide rule, it's not like a calculator. It's not digital. You don't get the exact answer. You get an approximate answer, but normally within 2 to 3 significant figures, which should usually be enough for the job that you're trying to do. We have one of these scales on the top line here, A, which is the top line. We have another identical scale underneath it on B. So there are lots of different types of scale here, but I'm just using A and B. A is this one here, and B is underneath it. Let's say we want to multiply 3 times 4. 3 times 4. We look at A and we go to where 3 is, and we put the bottom one at 1 where 3 is. Then we go up 4, and then we read where 4 is on the original one, and you can see 4 is at 12 because it's 10, 11, 12. Just say we can do something else. Let's do something more complicated. 7. 7 is a complicated number. Let's multiply 7 by 7. 7 squared. So we put the number 1 at 7 here. 1 at 7. Then we go up to 7 at the bottom one. And it exactly comes up at 49. So that's cool. What logarithms do, and what this is a physical interpretation of, is that they change multiplication into addition. So we're multiplying two things, but actually we're just adding two lengths. The reason why this is useful, obviously 7 times 7, we know that in our heads. Just say we wanted to multiply, say 2, 3, 4, 5 times 6, 4, 5, 7. Okay, what we do, we turn that into 2.345 times 6.457, and let's do the sums. So we'll go to 2.345, 2.345, it's probably about there, and we go up to here, 6.457, 6.457, and that's almost exactly 15. Okay, so get rid of our things, so 3, that would tell me, literally within a few seconds, that 2345 times 6457 is 15 million. And why don't we just check that? 457 equals, wow, the real answer, 15,141,665. This gives us a handy idea of what the answer is going to be. Multiplication is addition, so division is subtraction. So let's say we want to divide 20 by 3. We go to 20, and we just basically need to take away 3. So we put 3 where the 20 is there, and go down to 1. And where is 1? We use our hairline here. Oh, look, it's 6, between 6.6 and 6.7. This is something which is kind of quite cool and fun and a bit of a historical relic. But it's not a particularly beautiful thing. Unlike my other slide rule, my prized possession, and this is the Holden Calculex. Okay, I'm gonna open it. It's from 1906, and it comes almost like, you know, like I'm proposing marriage to you, that I'm getting down on my bended knee and giving you Holden Calculex. Will you be my mathematical bride? So what this is it is a circular slide rule. So here we have the logarithmic scale along a line. In a circular slide rule, it's in a circle. Now, Just put that down for a second. This comes with this fantastic sort of set of instructions. The thing is, not that many people collect mathematical instruments. And so you probably get loads of, you know, this might have been found by someone just clearing out their attic, didn't know what it was. I mean, it can't have been more than a few dozen dollars. So, revised rules, tables, and formulae for the Holden Calculates, which is a circular slide rule. Now, this is just wonderful, absolutely wonderful. Price 1/6, that's a penny, is it? I don't know, I'm too young, even though I'm old, to understand old English things. I'm going to read you a story. Although the ordinary slide rule is usually acknowledged to be a most useful and reliable instrument, it has one or two great disadvantages. For instance, it is a most inconvenient article to carry about in one's pocket. Also, in the hands of the average user, it is rendered almost useless for any unusual calculation. So, in other words, couldn't put this in a pocket, and it's not very elegant. On the other hand, the Holden Calculates is beautiful. It's like a pocket watch, and it's something that if you ever needed to do fast, approximate analog calculations on the fly, and it was 1906, you could whisk this out. Here, there are two moving parts. There is, you're moving this logarithmic scale against the top one, so two sides, and you've got the hairline. Here, you can move the middle one, and you've got the hairline. So again, there are lots of different scales for doing lots of different things. I'm just going to concentrate on multiplication and division. So just say again, we wanted to say, do 4 times 5, and we can see, if you can sit close up, we know it's 20, and it's on 20.
This is lovely, this thing. What do you do with this?
What do? You do calculations.
What do you do with it?
What do I do with it? I sort of take it out and stroke it and polish it and put it up there and, you know, talk to it. Quite a lot of times things are just made for being functional. And this is something which is not only is it functional, it is a rather beautiful object. And it's, you could say it's a kind of iPhone of the, you know, early English 20th century, because this is the height of technology packaged with beauty.
Thanks to Audible.com for supporting this video. Audible has more than 180,000 downloadable titles across all types of literature, including fiction, non-fiction, and periodicals. I'm an Audible user and particularly enjoy listening to books when I'm walking the dogs or driving the car or slogging along on the treadmill. They really make the time pass so much more quickly. Now, among Audible's huge collection is a book by Alex Belos, the person you just watched talking about slide rules. Here's Alex's Adventures in Numberland, super easy to find and download onto your Audible app. Why not check that one out? To find out more about how to do it, go to audible.com/numberphile. There you can sign on for a 30-day free trial, including your first book, and see what you think. That's 30 days free trial. It's a great service, easy to use, and our thanks to Audible for supporting the channel.